This sword's a replica of a sword that's in the Fitzwilliam Museum at Cambridge. It's nearly finished. All of it was made here in this forge. It's all traditionally made, hand-forged, hand-tempered. No machining there at all. It's an early example of a hand and a half. The blade is long. You would thought it would have been used on foot. It's actually meant to be used on a horse. It gives you more reach. The guard is just a very, the crosspiece is just a very simple crosspiece, as you can see. And why it's called a crosspiece is basically it's a cross that goes across the top. The pommel is called a Brazil nut pommel. In this case, it is a really heavy pommel to actually counterbalance the sword. The type of person that would use this is just generally called a thug. It is no lightweight piece of kit. It's a traditional forge, it's charcoal powered. The charcoal is actually made here on the estate. There's no electricity, everything here is hand powered. To see the temperature of the metal, we need the forge dark. In there, it's colossally dark. I've been ill for about 8 months, so I haven't done much work. I think it was built around the sort of 1800s, and nothing much has changed. Bellows are in the back room, they're traditional bellows. You pull the string, it pumps the bellows. There's a fuel store in the back there, and as you can see from the gap, just because it's not glowing doesn't mean it's not hot. So assume everything's hot. Thing to remember is it's exactly like stiff plasticine. When you're hitting it, the metal moves somewhere. So you have to work out where the metal is going to move to. It's actually a development of a helmet called the bassinet, which is the helmet underneath without the visor. There's things in the forge called stakes, and what they are basically metal balls on sticks. They fit into the anvil and you beat the metal over them repeatedly till you get the shape. They have quite a long life because these sort of things were expensive. So once you made one, if you were the top chap wearing it, as soon as it became unfashionable, you handed it down to your man-at-arms. It would fit the general sort of person. What you've got here is basically a linen lining with a head adjuster to make it comfortable and to keep it away from your head. Otherwise, it may be metal, but your head next to a piece of metal, somebody whacks the metal, it's not pleasant. They may have stuffed even grass or straw in there to give a little bit of extra padding. It will stop the cutting force, it won't stop the impact. Again, it's all just hard work, heating it up and heating it, using it the simplest processes possible, exactly as they did in the Middle Ages.